Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning, taken from the book Straight Ahead, written by Adley A. Estep, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, Putting God First. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. It says, But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. Children, nearly everyone in America has heard of Robert Ripley, of Believe It or Not fame, and of Robert Littornoo, the famous builder of earth-moving equipment. Mr. Ripley invited Mr. Littornoo appeared on his radio broadcast of September 27, 1940. Here are a few of the questions and answers that will be of interest to every Christian boy and girl. Ripley asked, Tell what happened after you made God your partner. Littornoo answered, The minute I started that partnership, business boomed. The next year, my sales were over $100,000. The second year was over $150. The third year was over $200,000. Then we hit almost $400,000. It kept going like that, in leaps and bounds. In 1939, our sales were over $7 million. Ripley asked, All because of your partnership with God. What was God's share in your business? Littornoo answered, I set aside 90% of the stock for God's use. Ripley asked, Then actually 90% of your personal wealth goes to Christian activity? I understand that in the last year, more than $1 million of your profits went to God's work. Littornoo answered, Yes, to date more than $10 million has been God's share. Ripley asked, Then you keep very little money for yourself? Littornoo answered, Yes, you see, I don't feel that my brain made this money. I believe that the Lord made it possible for me to make it, and I'm only returning to God what belongs to Him. My motto is not how much of my money I give to God, but how much of God's money do I keep for myself. Mr. Littornoo has said that he believes if every businessman could realize the opportunity he has to serve God in his business, the world and business would be far different and better. Here is a man who believes that every man will be happiest when he finds God's place for him. His testimony said with conviction. From the minute I made God my business partner, things started to go. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, a truly inspiring experience of faith. Children, let's look at this statement once again. It's not how much money I give to God, but how much of God's money do I use for myself? Children, today, give yourself a challenge to make God first. You will do everything by putting God first. Give the blessings you have first to support God's work through all the talents that God has entrusted to you. Use them to serve God first. Children, remember the advice of God's word this morning. But seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. Not just 1, 10, 100, or 1,000, but all of them will be added to you. And when you dare to put God first in your life, then you will have the same testimony. With full confidence, you will say, "Since I made God my business partner, everything has gone smoothly." May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.